is sin. You have to reach that point in your life where you can't stand sin, where it just disgusted you. You want nothing to do with it. When you hear gossip, you got to get away. When you see sin in the camp, when you see gossiping going on, you got to say, hey, my brother, hey, my sister, that's sin. It's going to stop God's hand from moving. It's going to stop God's hand from taking this church, this body of Christ, where it needs to get. If you've been gossiping, get rid of that sin. If you've been talking about your leader, get rid of that sin. You've been keeping their big donations, get rid of that sin. You've been stashing money in your locker, get rid of that sin. God sees all, it's the little things. It's not the big things, it's the little things. There's sin in the camp. The homes that they're repairing, they should be filled with food. Should be filled. There's sin in the camp. If someone's stashing money, bring them out to the line. God wants to take us to another level. It's the little things. It's the little things. Can't be faithful when the little, when they say turn in the 20s, the 10s and up. We can't be faithful in that. But you want a ministry? You can't get rid of that AI. Still struggling in that area. Keeping the big donations. Still struggling. They're sitting in the camp. They're sitting in the camp. The little things. It's the little things. God sees when you take under the banner, you put it away, you're stashing it for your selfish ambition. God sees it. There's sin. I'm saying sin because you got to recognize it. You got to embrace it. You got to receive it. Don't let it go one ear out the other. Embrace it and fix it. Don't let that stop the hand of God from flowing in your life. Don't let that money steal your blessing. Don't let that $50 bill, $100 bill, you're going to lose. You're going to rob God. You don't pay your tithes. Sin. You're stopping the hand of God from moving. It's biblical. Will a man rob God? Certainly, yes, he will. If you're not paying your tithe, you got to pay your tithes. It's the little things, church. Little things. God dropped the big giant in your life. But now he wants to drop that selfish ambition. The pride. The arrogance. Slander. Hatred. Killing your brother in your heart. Killing your brother in your mind. There's sin in the camp. There's no unity. How can God move? Psalms 133 verse 1 says, how blessed is when brothers dwell together in unity. How blessed is in unity. We start paying our tithes. We start getting more of these nice chairs for the church. It's God's house. Don't rob God. Don't rob God. Don't gossip about your leaders. There's sin in the camp. Do you see it? Do you recognize the sin? What's stopping the hand of God from moving and flowing? We get rid of that. We put it away. We crucify it. We repent from it. We turn to Jesus. Turn to the one who dropped your giant. Turn to the one who restored your family. Turn to the one who loves you for who you are. There's no one that can love you the way that Jesus Christ loves you. There's no one can give you the peace that Christ can give you. Those little sins can't give you the peace. The world can't fill the void in your heart. But I know someone who can. And he died on the cross 2,000 years ago. He carried the little foxes as well. His name is Jesus Christ. He is the Savior of this world. He has never changed. He will always be the same. He'll always be there to rescue you. He'll never let you down. He'll never leave you nor forsake you. He'll be with you when it's hard. He'll be with you when it's rough. He'll heal you when you're sick. He'll put a smile when you got a frown. He'll pick you up and clean you up. Amen. When Joshua went to Ai, and they lost. When we go to a battle, there's always a winner, there's always a loser. When you enter a battle, there's one winner, one loser. God was taking Joshua, doing some great things. When he got to Ai, he lost. He couldn't understand why. Because there was sin in the camp. And today you're in your walk, you find yourself in defeat. Find yourself down because there's sin. And if you keep that sin and you embrace it, leads to another sin. But when you take that sin and you give it to Jesus, to the one that you gave your addiction to. You give it to the one who parted the sea in your life. You give it to the one who tore down the walls in your life. Takes it. Throws it as far as the east to the west. You're forgiven.